Today we have a Bobcat skid steer loader. This one has a wheels, and this Bobcat has a problem with a starter electrical circuit. Yeah, there's a issue. Sometimes it starts, sometimes it doesn't. It cranks occasionally, but sometimes it doesn't want to do it. What I was told, starter doesn't engage all the time. Sometimes you crank it, will only spin but won't engage. Most likely we have a problem with a solenoid. Starter solenoid doesn't pull the pinion gear to engage with the flywheel, and the starter only spins. But that's far as I know. Let's confirm the issue, do the basic diagnosis, checked everything before calling bad starter and put a new one in. Okay. As you probably notice, under the hood we have a Kubota diesel non-turbo V2203-E. Yeah, old school engine, very very reliable, but for engine to run it needs to start. Let's get started. First, as usual, before doing any deep diagnosis, we do the visual inspection. We check for loose wires, corrosion, rusties, crusties. Yeah, here's the battery, here's the starter, technician's dream, and nothing's on the way. That's like what you can imagine. Okay, as you can see here, battery is slightly oversized for the Bobcat, but we don't worry about it. As you can see, the bracket doesn't fit. We're looking for loose wires, rusties, crusties, corrosion. Terminal is clean. This is a negative mark just in case. Everything's tight, and a positive on the battery back. It's tight as well. No rusties, crusties, no corrosion. Wires are just fine. That's a red one from the positive. It is going to the starter main hot terminal over here, the top of the solenoid. We're checking here, everything's nice and tight, nothing's loose. I don't see any serious corrosion going on, just kind of low it aged. Yep, nothing's technically looking wrong so far. Wires are in place. All right, here's our negative wire, nice and clean, tight on both sides here. Nothing is loose as well at the connectors to the clamp, and it's red. Well, it's negative ground wire, but it's red, and it's coming to the engine ground, nice and tight, clean. And as you can see, this is also a body ground, engine ground from the battery. Let's go and check the battery voltage. I have a multimeter here, that's good. And yeah, let's see what battery voltage we have. That's very important for the starter circuit. Let me place my positive, touch the ground and see what voltage we have. And we have a perfect 12.7, fully charged, good start. Okay, let's switch negative here and see what voltage are we getting to the stud. We have a 12.7. So far so good, but the circuit is not loaded. We have to load the circuit and see, do we have any voltage drop? That's most important, because there's no current flow through the circuit. It's not very accurate measurement, because voltmeter only measures the potential between two points. Without having a loaded circuit with the current flowing, you don't get any evidence of faulty component till you load a circuit. Let's do that. For the next test, we can use a multimeter and see any volts voltage drop, but let's just use the simple test light. And if test light will go out when we crank, it means we have a serious issue with a voltage drop, and we'll probably have a bad continuity somewhere. Okay, let's connect our test light. First, before the doing test, always checked your equipment. Okay, I have my alligator end of the test light connected to the battery negative. As soon as we found the power, test light will lit like that. Yeah, beautiful. And same here. Yeah, our test light work. Now we need our alligator clip with extension, because I'm working by myself. I have no one to crank the engine for me, that I have to use it, and I have different ones, as you can see. They're like $7 from Amazon, very good deal. Ideally, when you're working with someone else who can crank the engine, you have to touch the main starter post here, the stud, at the center where the stud is. Don't touch the nut or the wire eye link, like that. Touch the stud, and when you crank, you shouldn't see the light go out. If light will go out, we have a serious voltage drop in the circuit. It might dim a little bit because our starter, the initial startup, pulls 200 amps and more of current, and the first spike, it can go up to 500 amps for a millisecond. That's why light can dim a little bit, but we want to see it go out. We'll check the voltage drop of the main stud and also the starter control stud. This wire is only hot when starter is in cranking position. Okay, let's do that. All right, I have my test light connected, as you can see, alligator clip and extension cable. Make sure I can see it when I will be cranking, otherwise how I will know? And remember, this wire is hot, make sure it won't touch the ground, otherwise you'll have the sparks. All right, let's go to the skid steer. It's cold outside, so we'll go through the glow plugs. Let's just turn the key to the on position. Okay, fuel solenoid is on. We have a glow plugs going. Okay, yeah. And glow plugs are counting. Okay, good. For the 3:02 hours. And as I was told, sometimes it starts, sometimes it just cranks. But we're mostly interested. You bet. Test light will go out. Okay. No. You get here. Starter motor turned, but it spun. But we didn't have any engagement from the solenoid. It rotated. Let's do one more time. Pay attention to the test light. Okay, glow plugs are cycled again. Beautiful. Yeah, that's our problem. Starter motor spun. It rotated, but this guy didn't want to engage. All right. And as you can see here, it was tap 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 with something heavy like a hammer or a big adjustable wrench, and see if we have luck to fire it up. Don't go too crazy, don't need to beat the solenoid, just a little bit, it's sticky, it might fire it up. Okay, let's do it. Will I start? Why not? Okay. No, not really. Okay. Keys off. And yeah. All right. Now let's test the voltage drop at the starter post, this little guy here. Same way we connect it to the stud, as you can see here. Yeah, and well, you will see the power on a stud when key is in crank position. Okay, same thing. We want to see constant light. We might dim a little bit, that's okay, but we don't want light go out if we have a serious voltage drop. Okay, solenoid is on. That was a fuel shot of solenoid. Glow plugs are cycling one more time. This guy, open the fuel. Okay, light is off. Let's glow plugs off. Okay, let's crank it. Beautiful. It tried to start, but didn't crank, only rotated. And yeah, let's check one more thing. Engine block ground, make sure that's good, and we should be called the bad starter, actually bad solenoid. Okay, one more test and last test will take us a minute. Let's check the engine ground. We still have our test light connected to the battery negative, and let's connect our alligator clip to the engine ground cable over here where the starter is. And yeah, a nice bite. And if we have a bad engine ground while cranking, my test light will lit. Now test light is off, but yeah, let's see, let's crank it over, see what will happen. Keys on, glow plugs are on as well. Let's wait for 10 seconds, and the test light is off. That's good, because okay, glow plug relay is off. And if we will see the light, that means we have a bad engine ground. Let's crank it. Machine runs great, but as I said earlier, you have to start it before it will run. All right, and yeah, let's put a new starter. Yeah, I'm going to put a new starter. How to replace the starter on a Bobcat skid steer loader equipped with a Kubota diesel. Yeah, video will be down in the description, card over there, check it out. And thank you so much, guys, for your time watching this video. If it's helpful, informational, thumbs up, subscribe to the channel. And if you have any critics, comments, suggestions, recommendations, questions, put everything down in the comment section as well. Here's a starter, I already have it, I'm going to put it in. Yeah, check the video if you need it. And thank you so much again for watching this video. Take care. Bye-bye.